Renovations of the new debating chamber for the National Assembly started in April last year. The need for additional facilities and delayed payments to contractors have seen handover deadline extended 3 times. The contractor now has until January to complete the work and handover. Last month, works on the new chamber stalled after the Parliamentary Service Commission cancelled a tender to procure high-tech leather seats following suspicion that the price had been inflated. The retractable leather seats were to be imported from a European furniture manufacturer at a cost of 400,000 shillings each. Taxpayers will have forked out 144 million shillings to fit 360 seats in the chambers. To save money, the Prisons Department was approached and indicated it could design similar seats at a cost of 220,000 shillings each. The materials, including wood and leather, will all be sourced locally and the seats delivered in 90 days.
We also want to confirm from Prisons Department that they are able, as they proposed, to have these seats manufactured in different prison industries in the Republic so that we can fast-track the process.
The new chamber has been redesigned into a horseshoe model. New air conditioning equipment will be fitted. Lawmakers will also have workstations.
I came with a suggestion which was approved by the Parliamentary Service Commission that we must have the workstation in solid timber because there has to be a history about furniture which is in Parliament. So this is Kenyan hard wood.
Cameras will be installed to facilitate live broadcasts of debates. Members will also vote electronically after logging in with secure cards.
Unlike the Tanzanian Parliament, where you find names of honorable members printed on desks, we are not going to do that here. MPs can sit anywhere and they log in. So once you log in, the speaker will see you and your name will also appear on the screen.
Once completed, the new debating chamber is expected to be an ultra-modern facility and might probably reduce cases of lack of quorum that are common in Kenyan Parliament. Patrick Amimo, KTN Prime.